Hey guys and welcome to the German Duel Masters channel. This is Spalding here and today I will present you the winning deck profile from the IDC 2 tournament. If you also want to participate in one of our international tournaments, feel free to check out the DM Reborn forum where Alpha will post updates on upcoming tournaments. So yeah, this deck has quite a lot of names, to be honest. That is called Fire, Water, Nature aggro. It can be called Ruck aggro or even Bombazar Blue, without Bombazar, of course. I personally like Ruck aggro because I also play Magic, and there you have some Ruck decks too. And yeah, for those of you who don't know what Ruck stands for, it is for red, blue and green. The letter B is for black, so you have U for blue. So I will talk about the deck and the ratios I have and also the card choices. So let's get right into it. First of all, I play 8 two drops, and in my opinion the best two drops in the TCG for these colors. They are Quixotic and Gonta. Some honorable mentions are Kukpollon and Rikabu's Screwdriver. Also Emerald, but you don't have the mana consistency to play it on turn 2, and you really want to have a bigger body to attack and not get traded in, so I like Quixotic and Gonta. You can of course play more than 8, but I like this count because you are not a rush deck, and you want to have more cards with higher value. So I like 8. Yeah. Next up, we have the 3 drops. I play 14 in total, but when we look at it, you only play like real 11 because Soul Swap you will not play on turn 3 ever. So you have 4 Hercules, 4 Tribe and 3 Magnus. If you have to decide what to play on your third turn, then you will most of the time play Hercules and Tribe because they will stick on the board and not get bounced back. There is also an argument for playing Magnus on turn 3, and that is if you have a 2 drop and have Lucky Ball in hand, so you can break 2 shields on your third turn and then play Lucky Ball on turn 4, already triggering its effect. Yeah, for turn 4 plays, you have your 3 Lucky Ball. You can also play a 3 drop on turn 4, of course, which you saw me do in the semi-final and the final matches, where I played Magnus on turn 4 quite sometimes. You also can skip your 4 drops because you have Bronze on Tribe and can play a 5 drop on turn 4. This is why I only play like 3 4 drops. Now to the 5 drops, I play 3 Windex, 2 Terror Horn and 3 Searing Wave. I like these ratios. Especially the Windex one. I would not recommend you to play 4 Windex because you sometimes rely on getting an untapped mana source from the top of your deck when you play Awesome Tribe or Windex. And you saw me charging quite a lot multicolor cards in the semifinal and finals of the IDC 2 tournament, and also in the group stages, so maybe there's even an argument for cutting Windex down to 2, but it is a really good card in this deck. He can remove an opponent's blocker and also giving you a mana to play like double 3 drop or Lucky Ball and 2 drop on the next turn without giving up a hand card to charge for mana. Yeah, the 2 Terror Horn, you can search any card in the deck. Most of the time you want to search like a Magnus or even in some situations a Scarlet Sky Terror, which I play as a one-off. I have Scarlet Sky Terror in the deck because this card wins you games all by itself against a huge blocker wall, which you can find in Guardian Controls, in Hydro Hurricane decks, and in Merino decks with Initiates. So, yeah, I really like Terrorhorn at 2. Singwraith is also a really, really good card in this deck because it can answer threats which you cannot easily remove, something like Yuliana, which is a problem for this deck. You can't Soulswap out, you can't target it with Windex, and it also removes 3k blockers like Xerius, and also of course the small creatures which you can find in like Rub decks, in Coral, Hulkus, Locomotiva. So the Rub decks cannot easily play Meltdown and swing for game in one turn. And the last card, or the last two cards I play, are 4 Surfer and 2 Arc. I play 4 Surfer because it is the best shield trigger in the stack, and I also need more blue mana sources to cast Hulkus on turn 3 consistently. The Arc is, of course, for a heavy discarding metagame. So, as you saw in the IDC 2 tournament, I was the only player not playing Darkness, so there was a lot of discard going around, so 2 was definitely the best choice. But there's also argument for only playing 1 or even none of the Arceus if your local meta even aren't playing a lot of Darkness cards. So yeah, these are also the flex spots in the deck. The 2 Arceus, the 1 Sky Terror, and you can always change the ratios, maybe play like 2 Singwraith instead of 3, and 2 Magnus instead of 3, so you can play more 2 drops if you like, or even play Twincan Sky Terror, which I tested. I played 2 Sky Terror instead of 1 Singwraith and 1 Magnus, but ultimately I decided against it, even though you can swap it out. But by the time you get to play your Sky Terror, you already attacked a lot of times, and your opponent, if your opponent only has 1 shield left, then double Magnus is better than 1 Sky Terror, of course, which you saw me do against Telfer in game 3. And yeah, feel free to comment, like and subscribe, and I will look up for your critical opinions on this deck, and I will try to answer your questions. Have a nice day.